And the hits just keep coming here at Origins Game Fair. It is still day two. It is Friday. And I get to join Michael Coe. Yes, from Gamelyn Games once again. Good to see you.
Hi, Jeff. Thanks. I can't believe it's day two only. I'm pretty exhausted.
I got here Wednesday myself, early. And I usually don't come in on Wednesday. I'm like, it's only Friday? Wow. I know how you're feeling.
Yeah, it's been a good show, though, so far.
Well, that's all that's important. So let's talk a little bit about what's cooking. One thing I'm excited to actually see is Heroes of Land, Air, and Sea is available again.
Yes.
You can buy it.
Yes, we finally got our second printing in, which has sold out, but that means it's in stores. That means you can actually go around and find it right now.
You know, sold out at the distributor level.
So that, which is great. And the game has been super hot. We have it here set up at Origins, actually, at our booth, and we got a big 7-player game going.
I'll shoot some B-roll because it is very, very impressive. It is a large game.
It's a lot of fun to look at.
Play with 7 players. Yeah, it's going to take up a little bit of space on the table, folks.
Yeah.
So that is back available. There's some expansions to it as well, correct?
Yeah, that's right. So the Pestilence expansion, which is what expands it to 7 players, that was coupled with the second printing of the base game and the first expansion, the 5-6-player expansion.
Right.
So that's all available right now. Everything that is out that's been made for the game is available.
Cool. And then there's that 20-player expansion that's on the
line. Oh, yeah. Well, I told you not to say anything about that one.
I know. I'm not good at embargoes. I'm just not. Actually, I'm really good at embargoes.
I promise to not make a 10-hour game, okay?
No, because most people know Gamelyn Games from the fantastic Tiny Epic line of games. And the most recent release was Tiny Epic Zombies, which I reviewed, thought it was a blast. The gang loved it.
Thank you for that.
Yes, loved it. Not the typical kind of zombie game. It's very, very different, so that was cool too.
Good to hear.
Love the artwork as well. And there's another Tiny Epic game that's on the horizon.
Yes. So Tiny Epic Mechs followed Tiny Epic Zombies, and that's delivering to Kickstarter backers right now.
Yes.
That's that awesome arena game, action programming.
A little King of the Hill.
Yep, King of the Hill kind of stuff.
Big, like, mech.
Yeah, plastic mech suits.
Where
they open up
to the big mech.
Oh yeah, they have lots of accessorizing. It's a lot of fun. So that's going out to backers. Some have already received it. That'll be available next month for general purchase and general retail.
Oh, wow, okay.
So that's
so
really
people don't
soon.
Have to wait till like Gen Con.
Nope, they can get it soon. We'll have it at Gen Con as well. Okay. But yeah, hit your FLGS and pick one up next month if you're interested. And then after that, we have Tiny Epic Tactics. And that one, I personally am just incredibly excited about. I grew up playing Tactics kinds of games.
Sure.
Final Fantasy Tactics, yeah. Tactics Ogre, you know. And that game really pulls on the heartstrings of a game like that. That one's in production right now. And our estimated delivery to backers is in November. So, I'm hoping we can beat that a little bit. But we'll see how that goes. But that one is cool. It's definitely our most ambitious Tiny Epic games so far, and that's saying a lot, I think.
Now, one thing that I found really striking when I saw the Kickstarter info, and of course I shared it, was the way that there's like little boxes. You'll actually utilize these little boxes to create different levels.
Yes.
So you've got like the little realm there.
So people that know our Tiny Epic games, they know that they don't usually have inserts because they're just so crammed stuff. So in this one, you actually have little inserts, and they're going to hold your cards and your pieces. But those inserts are boxes that are printed on, both on the exterior and interior. So on the inside, they're printed to be a dungeon. On the outside, they're going to be some overworld. So you take all those boxes out, and they're all different shapes and sizes. And then you also use the bottom of the game box, which has exterior printing. And that is also a big mountain. And then you get a little scroll, a silk scroll. It's really high quality. Lay that out, and then you build your map. And so you end up with all these various levels of mountains and caves, and there's a little castle.
Yeah, there's a lot going on.
Yeah, it's a grid-based, so you're just kind of moving across the grid on this map, trying to, you know.
Kill monsters and stuff?
Well, so it depends on how you're playing it. There's in the solo and cooperative mode, yes, you're killing monsters, and you're scouring those dungeons. In the competitive mode, in the team play, it's going to be you versus other players, so it's the little skirmishes, and you're trying to control areas, so it's control points and stuff. So,
That's one thing that I had noticed, and you really kind of kicked that off with Tiny Epic Zombies, was creating all these different game modes just in that one boss.
We will not sleep. We will not sleep until we have figured out how to give you more game in a box at a good price than any other publisher in the world. That's our goal.
Well, I have to say, from everything that I've ever played from Gamelyn Games, it is certainly packed with gameplay. It really is. You didn't write me a check or anything for me to say this. It's really true.
If I did, amazed. I'm sorry. Don't cash it.
Then I'll make Scott pay me then. No.
He's got the money, so yeah, he needs to write you the check.
But yeah, that's one of the things that really impressed me. And the first Tiny Epic game that I was exposed to was Tiny Epic Western, which is a phenomenal game.
Yeah.
It was a blast.
It's a great game.
Yeah. And if you have not played it, thinking it's just some Western game, definitely check it out, because it's a Western theme, but there's a lot going on. It's cool.
It's got a real unique twist to poker. You're playing three-card poker with worker placement and a Western theme. Yeah, it's you got these really awesome bullet dice that are shaped just like bullets. Very thematic.
Michael, anything else that's cooking, maybe percolating, that you can share? I know you got loads of stuff going on, but anything you can share about what might be on the horizon?
Well, for Tiny Epic fans, we have a really exciting new Tiny Epic game. We actually have two new Tiny Epic games that are pretty far along in development. One, the illustrations are about halfway done. And then for Heroes of Land, Air, and Sea fans, we have something pretty exciting brewing behind the scenes.
So these are the announcements you make tomorrow, right? Because that's how it usually works. I mentioned this in another interview. It's like, never fails. It always seems like I do an interview with somebody, and then the next day at the con, they make some big announcement. And I'm like,
hey, how did I miss it by a day?
Couldn't have done that yesterday.
That's funny.
It is funny.
They won't be announced tomorrow, I can promise you that. Yeah. So I'll be the one guy that doesn't make you know, hurt your feelings there the next day.
Hurt my feelings. It's just funny.
So we do have a lot of stuff that's in the works. Yeah. Very exciting things.
And of course, I know I'll get an email all about it, and I'll share it with everybody out there too.
Yep.
Any final words you want to share with our audience out there?
Game on. Have a lot of fun. It's a great industry, and it's a great time to be part of this industry.
It is a golden age. That
is
for certain. Michael, once again, thank you so much for chatting with me.
Thanks, Jeff. Take care.
Enjoy the show.
Thanks.
Thanks for watching my Origins Game Fair 2019 coverage. If you'd like to see more convention coverage, click right here. And if you'd like to see a somewhat random video from the Gaming Gang channel, including recordings of the live Monday through Friday episodes of The Daily Dope, click right here. Once again, I'm Jeff McAleer. Thank you very much for watching, and please subscribe.